Have you ever wondered how successful e-commerce companies handle all of that product information that's needed to sell their products? The secret isn't having a big team or a ton of money. It's setting up a system that's intuitive and scalable. Successful businesses know that having detailed product data that's accurate and up to date is extremely important to their success. So when it comes to maintaining that data, they use a dedicated product information management system. Now, what is that and what does it mean? This video is going to be your one-stop guide to all you need to know about product information management, also known as PIM, including what it is, what it isn't, what it does, which types of companies can benefit from it, and so much more. And at the end of this video, I'll give you access to a free guide that you can download that will help you select the right system. But first, what is PIM? Well, PIM, or product information management as a concept, isn't new. While software dedicated to this can be relatively new, which I'll explain next, the concept itself has existed for as long as there has been product information to manage. To understand this better, we need to understand what product information we're talking about. Product information, which in the world of commerce is known as product attributes, refers to all of the details and the characteristics that are relevant to market and sell a product. Take, for example, this t-shirt, or really any product that your company sells. You, of course, have some internal information about it, so SKU, wholesale cost, product status. Then you have the essentials, like the size, the color, the price. There's technical information like measurements, composition, care instructions, warranties. Marketing information like product title, descriptions, features, and translations. Not to mention digital assets like pack shots, lifestyle photos, videos, and maybe even documents like instructions. Now, depending on the product, there can be a lot more information involved. And if the product has variations, like different sizes, colors, or models, then multiply that information by all of the variations. This is where the concept of product information management comes in. Every company has a way of managing all of that product data. They might not be doing it in the most efficient way. Maybe they're using spreadsheets or a combination of different tools, but it is being managed somehow. Think of it like keeping track of your friend's contact information. Before smartphones, you might have used a paper phone book with scribbled notes and crossed out numbers. It might not have been the most efficient system, but it got the job done. Now with smartphones, everything is stored in the cloud, easy to search, and you can add extra details like email addresses and birthdays. You can also update it easily and transfer all of that information to a different phone if you need to. PIM software is like that digital contacts app on your phone. PIM software is a dedicated tool that helps you manage all of your product information more efficiently by keeping it all together and offering specific features that make updating and sharing that information easier. Now, maybe you're thinking, wait, I have software that helps me manage my product information. I manage it in my e-commerce platform, or I have my ERP. Isn't that the same thing? That's a really great question, and I'm going to go over this next. But in order to assess whether these other tools are the best option for managing your product information, we need to understand what PIM software is supposed to do in the first place. PIM software helps you manage all of your data more efficiently by focusing on four phases or pillars of managing product information when it comes to commerce: centralization, management, optimization, and distribution. The most important part or step of managing product data efficiently is having all of that data together in one place. PIM software provides a central source of truth where you can store all of the information that you need to sell a product. And we're not just talking about basic information like SKU, price, and product name. We're talking about every piece of information, including your digital assets. This is really important because many companies manage digital assets completely separate from the rest of their information and end up having to hunt that information down when they're needed. Thankfully, PIM software solves this with integrated digital asset management, or DAM features, which you can learn more about in the guide that I mentioned earlier. I mean, take this PIM software user, for example, who says that their PIM software replaced various spreadsheets, PDFs, and media folders into an easy-to-use platform. It consolidated their product information, their vendor information, their media files, and their selling points all into one platform. All right, now, having all of this information together is just the first step. You also need to manage it well. It's important to organize your products so that they're easy to find, view, and edit, because ultimately, this ensures that all of the necessary details are filled in for your clients or for uploading them to different sales and marketing platforms. Keeping this information accurate and up to date is key because it directly impacts your business's credibility and efficiency. When your product details are correct, it builds trust with your customers, leading to fewer returns and complaints. It also helps avoid costly mistakes like sending out the wrong prices or product descriptions. PIM software can help by letting you set user permissions, customize views, and organize your data in ways that other tools just can't. For example, you can manage products and their variations together. You can see how products are related, and you can use filters to create clear product lists. Think of it as having one master spreadsheet, but where different users can adapt it to their needs and work on it at the same time without needing to make their own copy. For example, this user here, who's mentioned that since adopting PIM software, each department and team member at their company can create different views and attributes that work for them without having to see information that is not relevant to them and without having to interfere with other team members' workflows. The next pillar is optimization. As we all know, selling your products isn't as simple as listing them and waiting for the sales to come in. I wish it were. There is the never-ending task of continuously optimizing your products, whether it's to meet specific channel requirements or for SEO to make sure that your products are ranking and reaching the correct audience. For example, the product information that you need to sell on your online store might not be the same that you need to meet the requirements to sell on Amazon or on another marketplace. And that might not be the same as the information that you need to send to your clients directly. You might need to adjust the prices for clients if they buy in large quantities or if you need to ship it a specific way. PIM software has features that let you do that at scale in order to save you time, whether it's by making bulk changes to specific attributes, by quickly formatting and transforming data with formulas, or even tracking the quality and completeness of that data. For example, this user here says that his team saw an increase in product updates and listing creations of over 500% and reduced the time that it took to do this from weeks to days. Or this one, who's able to track that they have all of the necessary information for Shopify, and then they can then enrich it for Google and other SEO needs. PIM software then wraps this up beautifully with features that simplify the process of distributing all of this optimized information across your various sales and marketing channels, such as online stores, marketplaces, distribution and retail partners, and platforms like Google Shopping. It includes features for creating product feed templates that meet marketplace requirements, generating price sheets for partners, and setting up brand portals for your sales teams. The main benefit here is that you'll only need to update your product information once, and the PIM software will automatically update it across all of your feeds, your price sheets, and so on accordingly, without you having to do so manually. This user, for example, has their data go directly from their PIM software to several e-commerce platforms, POS, and B2B channels. And this one uses product sheets and brand portals to export information with a personalized template to help their sales team. All right, now that you know what PIM software does, you might realize that you've come across this software in different names. There are PIM software providers that refer to themselves as product content management, product data management, product resource management, and some even call it product experience management. As long as the software can successfully manage the four pillars that I just went through, the name doesn't really matter. However, you do need to be cautious when looking at software with other names, because while some of them might fit the description of PIM software, others might be referring to a completely different type of content management. Now, I know this can get a little bit tricky, so at the end of this video, I'll show you where you can find more resources that explain all of this more in depth. But before that, let's clarify some common misconceptions that can end up really affecting the scalability of how you manage your product data. Earlier, I mentioned ERPs. I've been asked more times than I can remember, why get PIM software if I already have an ERP software? Typically, ERPs can only handle a small set of information, usually the product's SKU, price, and a thumbnail. Sometimes it can handle a little bit more, but you'll run into limitations when you want to handle product variations and rich product data. This user here specifically mentioned that with PIM software, she was able to add variations and various data that her ERP system just couldn't handle. Not to mention that ERPs are missing a lot of the features for optimizing and distributing your product data. I have a whole video that explains the difference between ERP and PIM software, and that explains how they can be used together, which I'll include in the description of this video. I also have a free downloadable guide on how to make the most of ERP and PIM software. So if you want that, just write ERP PIM guide in the comments and I'll send it to you. Now, I know not everyone has ERP software, but if you're selling online, then you do have your online store, right? A lot of people wonder why can't they use their CMS or their marketplace as their product information management system? Well, remember how at the beginning of this video, I mentioned that successful companies set up systems that are scalable? Using your sales platform as your PIM system doesn't allow for that. Most platforms only allow you to store information that's relevant for that specific platform. So if you want to adapt it to other platforms or clients, you'll need to export it and manage it from a separate location, which usually just ends up being one or more spreadsheets. And as Robert here said it, it's a mess. Some other things to keep in mind is that PIM software is not feed management software or inventory management software or price management software or a CMS, but these all do work very well together to create a really strong tech stack. Okay, now you know what PIM software is, you know what it isn't, you know what it does, but does your business need it? And if so, who in your company would even use it? PIM software isn't just for big companies. Both big and small companies can benefit. Whether you're a retailer, a reseller, a manufacturer, a distributor, or a wholesaler, PIM software can help simplify your product information management. Of course, like most things in this world, it's not a matter of whether you need to get a PIM or you don't need to get a PIM. It's all about cost benefits. To know whether your business needs PIM software, you should understand what you're trying to solve for. You now know what PIM software does. So look within your company and try to gauge what are the bottlenecks and what's draining most of your team's time and resources. If you're not sure where to start, don't worry because I've got you covered with a video that I'm linking somewhere here in this video that explains these 6 signs you can look for to know if PIM is right for you. And if there's anything missing, just drop me a message and I will be more than happy to help you. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel because it'll help other people find this video. See you next time.